Meet Laurie Barge, astrobiologist at the Jet Propulsion Laboratory. I sat down with her during an astrobiology conference in Goddard Space Flight Center, and we talked about Are We Alone? She's written articles about thermodynamics and how life could have gotten started in hydrothermal vents, and she's also interested in education, astrobiology outreach. Let's hear what she has to say about Are We Alone?
My name is Dr. Laurie Barge from the NASA Jet Propulsion Laboratory.
What part of your research is most relevant to answering the question, are we alone?
Well, I study the planetary environments in the solar system mostly, so things like Mars, Europa, Enceladus, the ones that we are going to visit in my lifetime, I hope. And so this will be looking at the soils and the ices and the oceans and what sort of chemistry can happen within. So I look at origin of life, prebiotic chemistry, but also how life can live there once it's established. Well, we're looking for signs of life on other planets, either microbial or otherwise, and defining what those signs are is one of the hardest challenges.
Now, a lot of people I talk to don't care about microbes. They're looking for sentient beings.
Oh.
And you're not looking for sentient beings?
I mean, that would be interesting as well, but I think we all should be interested in microbes because microbes were the first life on Earth. And so if life emerged somewhere else in a similar fashion, then maybe it would be the first life there too. And for a long time, Earth was mostly microbes. So it's important to consider, you know, when you're looking at the history of a planet, microbes could be the most dominant form and the most likely to find.
If I gave you $100 billion with the caveat you had to spend it to try to answer the question, are we alone, how would you spend it?
Well, I guess I would send a lot of missions. And I would also fund a lot of origin of life research in the lab.
Would you invest in microscopes to look for nano-aliens in like little spaceships from advanced civilizations?
Probably not.
Because?
I think that I would focus on looking for microbes because even though we have intelligent life on Earth, we also still have microbes. So it's a good bet that if you have life, you have microbes because that's how it started.
What are your best ideas about narrowing down the constraints on the site for the origin of life on Earth?
Well, I actually don't think that it's productive to try to predict which specific environment it happened in because it's more important as a chemist to look at the conditions for a reaction. So when we're looking at reactions in the lab, we may find that a certain condition promotes a certain reaction, and this is good. But then we often will jump to conclusions about which environments have that condition and which ones don't. And that's the sort of thing where we are often surprised in geology about which environments have certain conditions, especially when you consider exploring other planets. So it's best to be to say which conditions you would like to find, and then when you explore the solar system, be open to any environment that can provide that for you.